Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to discuss about the common resume format of any interview. Okay, let's begin our video. This is the common format of simple resume. Let's go in detail. First, you need to mention your name. Let it be simple. For example, R. Rakesh. Okay, no need to mention so lengthy names. Always keep it simple in resume. Next, you need to mention your father's name, son of so and so. Okay, next, date of birth. Date of birth is always better to have in a particular format, such as date, month, year. Okay, it is a standard format, so always better to follow this format. Next is, you need to mention your address. It's better if you mention your permanent address. Okay, always mention your permanent address. If you don't have if you are currently not living at your permanent address, then do one thing. First, mention your permanent address. Under that, mention your current address. Okay. And you need to mention house number, colony, everything in detail. Okay. So that whatever the company wants to post you in personnel, they'll be using with the help of this address only. So you need to mention very detailed address. Okay. Next, you need to mention your career objectives. If you want to make your resume a little more lengthy, you can do one thing. After permanent address and current address, you can add hobbies. You can add positives, I mean like strengths and weakness, like that. Okay, you can extend a bit using these all things in your resume. Okay, next, mention your career objectives. Like, what are your objectives which you wanted to achieve? Okay, or what are your goals? Something like that related. Okay, next, you need to mention your educational background. Educational background should be in this format. Okay, first, you need to mention your course, next, name of the college, year of passing, and how many marks you got during that year or during that degree. Okay, if you don't have percentage, then you need to mention your CGPA. Okay, CGPA also you can mention. And courses, many of your students will do a common mistake. They will start with 10th, next plus 2, next degree, next PG. No, this is ultimately the long procedure. Okay, how you need to mention is, first, your PG. Okay, if you don't have your PG, you need to mention first your UG, next intermediate, next 10th, like that. In the decremental order, you have to come. Okay, first mention your PG, UG, intermediate, and then 10th. Okay, there is a reason for mentioning in this particular order, because HR will not have so much time to look at your resume in detail. What he does is, he will just see the particular, like your highest degree and your CGPA or your percentage, and then decides whether you are applicable for this job or not. Okay, so always mention your highest qualification in the first line. Okay. Excuse me. Next, you need to mention your skills. Okay, if you are good at languages like Java, you can mention it. And if you have any soft skills, you can mention them. Or if you have any other skills, additional skills which helps for your job profile, which is relevant to your job profile, you can mention them. And after skills, you can also mention your certifications. If you have any certifications, those also you can mention. Okay, if you have Java certification or C, C++ something certifications, you can mention them, okay? It will be an added advantage. Next is you have to mention your academic achievements, okay? Most of the people will mention academic achievements as I won many prizes in school level competition, I sang a song in a school level competition. No, you should never mention those all things. What you need to do is academic achievements means always remember only you need to mention your college level achievements, okay? No school level achievements. You should always consider from your intermediate achievements as your academic achievements. This is the important point where most of the HRs will look after, okay? Remember, only your college achievements should be mentioned as your academic achievements, okay? And in your college, if you have participated any national or international level competition, something like that, you can mention them. And gold medals, prizes, all that you can mention, okay, as your academic achievements. And other activities means if you're a candidate of NSS or NCC, or you know, if you have any some other activities rather than your just education, you can mention them, okay? And if you are a school, if you are a college president, something like that, or union, you are a leader, or you know, some other activities which you did other than your education, you can mention in other activities, okay? This is the very simple format of the resume, okay? I'm repeating, first mention your name, next your father name, date of birth, coming to address. If you are not currently staying at your permanent address, then you have to mention your permanent address as well as current address in detail. Next, you can also mention your hobbies, strengths and weakness. Next, go with your career objectives. Next, educational background. And coming to educational background, you always start mentioning with your highest degree. And next, mention your skills, academic achievements. In academic achievements, never mention your school level achievements. Always make sure you mention only your college level achievements. And in other activities, if you have any, you can mention them, okay? So that's it for today. Hope you found this video useful. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such videos, and do share this video with all your friends and also help them out. And for more such videos, you know what to do. You just need to subscribe and hit the bell icon. And all the very best for your interview. Be confident, crack the interview, grab the opportunity. All the very best.